Out of grade school or high school, what was your first introduction to theater?
Theater, it wasn't really theater. It was putting on plays.
Right.
And it was something that happened at Christmas or something that happened at Easter, and usually some kid was dressed as a tree and someone was playing a cow. Yeah. And it was very, you know, we're putting on a show. It didn't really mean anything to me, and I certainly didn't think of it as theater, like going to see a play. I remember when we were in elementary in northern BC, there was a touring company that came through from Vancouver that did a children's show in the gymnasium that I remember being really thrilled by. But I didn't even relate that to theater in any way. It was just like these people who put on a play for our amusement. And it wasn't until I was actually in high school and taking drama classes that I started to get a sense that there were people out there who did this for a living. Mm-hmm. And then when I was in the 11th grade in Edmonton, I had a friend, we'd gone to junior high together, and he was really good in the drama class, and he'd gone to an uptown school called Vic Comp and was taking a performing arts program as his high school training. And I went to see a play there once, which was Philemon by Tom Jones and Harvey Schmidt, the same people who wrote The Fantastics, which is a musical about a kind of amoral clown in the sense of ancient Rome clown, who impersonates a religious leader to find out information from the Christians who've been imprisoned and is converted through that and becomes a Christian leader and a leader of the underground. And it's a musical. It was done on Broadway briefly, and it was done off Broadway. It did quite well in the early 70s. It's one of those black box musicals with seven people and an orchestra of four and some boxes and some sticks, and everything becomes everything else, and people play multiple characters. And I'd never seen anything like that before. And it absolutely blew me away. And I said, oh man, I've been wasting my time living out in Beverly in the East End of Edmonton. You know, I need to move downtown. So I transferred into Vic, into the performing arts program. And literally my life changed. I mean, up to that point I'd been kind of flunking out at school. I wasn't very interested. I wasn't doing very well. And I got into this program where we took fencing instead of gym, where we took theater history instead of social studies, where we did acting programs and dance and studied design and all of this stuff. And it allowed me to finish high school, because I wouldn't have finished it otherwise.
Now, it's very rare to have a performing arts school in at that time, because in Ottawa they had nothing.
Right.
So how did that start? Whose idea was it? Like, how did...
Well, I don't know exactly the full history of the program, but it had been going for quite a while. It had been going since the mid-60s, and it was started specifically for artistic Albertans, I guess that's what they called gay people in those days or whatever, who wanted to be part of the theater. There was no training program in all of Alberta, so the high school, which was a vocational high school as well as a academic high school, started this program, which was actually very big. It was the only place to train in Alberta for many years until the University of Alberta got their acting department together, and then that kind of took over. But a lot of the people from U of A went through Vic Comp initially before they went to the university, and it was very much a conservatory training program. I mean, we were high school kids, but we still had all this stuff we had to do, and we still put on three or four shows a year, and you had to be there to rehearse every night, and you'd come out at midnight, and it was wonderful. I mean, it was really a great group of people. It was like acting school. You lose half of them through attrition by Christmas, and the rest who stay are serious. And I started writing as well, because we're doing these plays like, you know, the Italian Straw Hat and stuff that was written for young people at the time. And I was like, oh, Jesus, man, these are terrible. I could write better than this. And so that's when I started writing, was specifically to respond to this stuff that had been written for young actors in the 40s. And it was like, no, man, it's the 70s. Things are different now. And the first play I wrote won the student category of the Alberta Culture Playwriting Competition in 1977, I think.
What was it called?
To Pariah at a Bus Stop in a Large City Late at Night.
That's a great title. What was
well, it is, except you only have to hear the title and then you can say, well, I think I've seen it. You know, it's like, what else can possibly happen? And it was like a Zoo Story ripoff. You know, it was two men on a park bench. I'd been very affected by Albie and the Zoo Story, and it was sort of my take on that, and when I won, I got like a cash prize, and they sent me to the Banff School of the Fine Arts to be the student playwright in the Playwrights Colony for 4 weeks.
Right.
So you're 17 years old, and you're 4 weeks in Banff with all of these old Canadian playwrights who are writing plays about mining disasters and wheat strikes, and it was like, oh my God, get me out of here. These people are so boring. And there's all these beautiful young actors and dancers and painters and all these people around who are doing all this artistic stuff, and they're all young and of the same age and having sex and carrying on and partying, and I'm stuck with all these old farts, right? So, but what it did though is it really made me realize I hated most of what everybody else was writing for the theater. That sitting through those readings about the things I just said had no, I didn't know how to relate to them in any way. I mean, from where I was coming from to where these people were coming from was so different, and even the stuff I was bringing in then was much kind of grittier and ruder, and they were sort of like, dude, what are you doing? Like, what is this stuff, you know? I was like, I don't know, this is
what
stuff.
What year was that in?
77.
77, yeah. So, well, also socially, a lot of stuff is happening in 77. So there's a lot of change happening.
It's the beginning of the gay movement as well, and I'm just getting a sense of that. And in fact, the first year I was at Banff, I met Paul Reynolds, the former producer of the Shaw Festival, and before that, a stage manager. He was there as a director. And he was the first gay man that I met who was out and upfront about it and didn't care what anybody thought. And he was, he made that entire trip worthwhile. He made the entire time I spent there worthwhile, because what he taught me about being a gay man was much more important and profound than anything I learned about playwriting in that time.